Hello everyone. Today we're going to talk about another interesting pigeon mutation, this one called Indigo. But before we start, I'd like to quickly introduce you to a new project of mine, pigeongenetics.com. The site is free to use and is broken up into two main parts, a forum for discussion about pigeons and their genes, and a Wikipedia-style encyclopedia for pigeon genes and breeds. This is a collaborative resource that you are welcome and encouraged to add your knowledge to. I'll leave links in the description, and I'd love it if you could check it out. Anyway, back to the video. Like I said in the beginning, Indigo is in my opinion quite an interesting mutation for two main reasons. The first is simply what it looks like. Indigo is a dominant mutation, which means that only one copy of the gene is needed to produce an effect. But the phenotype it produces is different depending on if the pigeon is heterozygous or homozygous for Indigo. Remember, heterozygous means one copy of the gene, and homozygous means two copies. Indigo is best expressed on a blue base colour. When a pigeon has just one copy of the Indigo gene, the blue wing shield and body feathers are slightly changed to a more grey or navy colour, and the wing pattern becomes a more reddish plum or chestnut colour. If a bird is homozygous for Indigo, though, the phenotype is entirely different, and can near perfectly mimic an ash red pigeon. Of course, Indigo isn't the only gene to express differently when heterozygous or homozygous. Other genes like Grizzle, Ice, and Stipper have similar effects, but I still think it's pretty interesting. Apart from its effects on the wing and body of the pigeon, Indigo also washes out the bird's tail bar, even when just heterozygous. Occasionally, Indigo can be confused for recessive opal, so I've included here a comparison of the tails of two of my birds, an opal and an indigo. The other fact about Indigo that I really like relates to its discovery. If you watched my White Pigeons Are Complicated video, you might remember me saying that the white feathering could potentially be hiding new and undiscovered mutations. And this is exactly what actually happened with Indigo. The gene was discovered in the United States in the 1930s in white carno pigeons. Although this gene was discovered in America in a French breed of pigeon, Indigo actually seems likely to be of Middle Eastern origin. It has been found to be present in a few Middle Eastern breeds since its discovery, and likely found its way into the carno breed through Middle Eastern birds brought into France in the 1600s to 1800s. So how do you breed indigo pigeons? Well, as I said at the start, indigo is a dominant gene. This means it isn't too difficult to reproduce, or even to bring the gene into a new breed. You simply need to use a pigeon that carries the gene, and you will breed more indigo birds. As it is dominant, you will almost always be able to tell visually if a bird has the gene, unless of course it is hidden by something like white. To bring indigo into a breed that doesn't yet have it, all you need to do is find an indigo pigeon and mate it with one of your birds, then use the indigo young to grade the colour back into the standard of the bird you're trying to breed. If a young bird from this project does not show indigo, it will probably not be useful in your project, as it does not carry the indigo gene. So now that we know the basics about the gene, what happens when we combine it with other traits? Some absolutely beautiful pigeons are produced, and we'll take a look at them right after this break. Okay, let's look at some pigeons. The gene that indigo is most commonly combined with is spread, and as you may remember from the pigeon gene spread video, the phenotype that it creates is called Andalusian. It is named after the similar colour in chickens. The typical Andalusian colour is a lacy navy blue, and is produced by combining heterozygous indigo with spread. Here is a really nice Andalusian bred by Neil Pratt. Remember though, indigo changes when it is homozygous, and the homozygous indigo Andalusian is very different. It produces a colour that I like quite a lot. The birds have a light lacy body, with darker navy or plum heads. This is a nice bird from Robert Bennion. Quite a few friends submitted pictures of their Andalusian pigeons for this video, so let's take a moment to appreciate them before moving on. Just as a quick side point, there is another very similar Middle Eastern phenotype called Gagadi. Surprisingly though, this colour does not contain indigo at all, and actually still remains a mystery waiting to be unravelled. Anyway, back to indigo. Another colour I really like is the combination of indigo with dilute. Here is one bred by Joe Cusick, and a group from John Cranny. These are some more very nice pigeons bred by Stephen Lee. Of course, you can also quite easily combine indigo with both dilute and spread at the same time, like this one by Thomas Cannon of the UK. Combining indigo with barless is quite interesting. Barless, of course, removes the windshield bars, and indigo washes out the tail bar, creating an almost totally blue pigeon. This one was bred by Lisa Marie Combrink, and another from Liviu Constantine. Spread and dilute are the most popular genes to combine with indigo, but there are breeders from all around the world working on some more unorthodox colours. Let's take a look at some of them now. Jamal Woodside is a breeder from the Bahamas who has been working on quite a few white bar pigeon projects, including with indigo. Jamal uses toy stencil genes to create the white pattern on his birds. Toy stencil isn't the only way to create white patterns though, and Robert Bennion of the United Kingdom has combined indigo with dominant opal to create a number of interesting phenotypes. Another breeder to work with the indigo dominant opal combination is Brendan Sensing, Pennsylvania. Brendan has also added spread to the mix, which creates a colour that some people like to call opal. Okay, so the main takeaways from this video are that indigo is a dominant mutation that expresses differently when heterozygous and homozygous, and the gene can be used to create some beautiful pigeons. I'd really like to thank the breeders who submitted images of their birds for this video, and we'll have a look at a few more to close it out. But please remember to check out pigeongenetics.com and let me know what you think about the project.